This episode is brought to you by Forney Industries, official sponsor of Faction 46 and Nice Motorsports Truck Series teams. Forney offers versatile welding and plasma cutting machines, along with a full line of metalworking accessories for beginners, do-it-yourselfers, and professionals. Forney has everything you need for your next metalworking project. Shop for these top-of-the-line products at foreyind.com, that's foreyind.com, or at an authorized Forney dealer near you.
Hey there, NASCAR fans. Have you got your copy of the latest edition of NASCAR Pole Position Print Magazine? If not, there's no better time than now to subscribe at polepositionmag.com. NASCAR Pole Position is the only print magazine covering NASCAR. Officially licensed by NASCAR, NASCAR Pole Position Magazine is published throughout the NASCAR season, and each edition is an instant collector's item, backed with great feature stories and photography. The magazine is even mailed to you in a poly bag for those who love to collect NASCAR memorabilia. At polepositionmag.com, you can even find past issues available to purchase. Get your subscription to NASCAR Pole Position and get great NASCAR content delivered straight to your mailbox throughout the season. Learn more at polepositionmag.com. That's polepositionmag.com.
Hey y'all, Rick Houston here, and I want to tell you about my new show, the Moonshine and Motorsports Racing Podcast. I've partnered up with the State of North Carolina Department of Natural and Cultural Resources to help uncover the history behind moonshining mountain boys, professional wheelmen, and the backwoods and city lights of the Tar Heel State. In the first episode, I sat down with Winston Kelly at the NASCAR Hall of Fame for a little behind-the-scenes gossip about Junior Johnson's engineering skills.
He's got two things in his hand, pipe wrench and channel lock pliers, and they weren't new. They had been around the block a time or two.
Wasn't the first deal they built, I bet.
No. The pliers had been red before, but paint had worn off.
And in the second episode, I talked to a professional hillbilly, a.k.a. Dr. Daniel Pierce of UNC Asheville, to find out the real history of moonshiners and their battles with the revenuers.
He wrote about one of his experiences of trying to chase down this bootlegger and this souped-up car, and he complained that the government gave him these piece of crap, cheapo cars, and that were really no match, but he thought he was doing pretty good, and then the guy just hits it and just takes off and practically disappeared. But then the guy makes a bootleg turn and comes back towards him. And as he said, it was a game of chicken, and I was the chicken. And so he ran off the road. And actually, he was the guy who caught Junior Johnson at his daddy's still when Junior got tangled up in a barbed wire fence.
So check out the Moonshine and Motorsports Racing Podcast, available on YouTube, DailyDownforce.com, and all of your favorite podcasting platforms. And be sure to check out my regular show on NASCAR history, the Scene Vault Podcast. Hey, this is Rick Houston, and welcome to the Moonshine and Motorsports Podcast. Together, we're going to figure out the connection between moonshine, motorsports, and North Carolina. The inspiration for this show came from my friends at the North Carolina Department of Natural and Cultural Resources. They are the group responsible for creating the Moonshine and Motorsports Trail, which celebrates the state's history of distilling and racing, fueling economic development and cultural tourism. You can walk nearly the entire tour by visiting dailydownforce.com/moonshine and motorsports. And while you're at it, don't forget to check out my regular show on NASCAR history, the Scene Vault Podcast. Hello, my name is Rick Houston, and I'm here to introduce you to the Moonshine and Motorsports Podcast, a weekly show that will be coming to you every other week on all your favorite podcasting platforms and YouTube. I guess we should start out by talking about my own background with liquor. Well, the fact is, I don't have one. I'm a teetotaler from way back. The most I've ever done is a sip or two when I'm really, really sick, in an attempt to bring what ails me to its knees. The bottom line, I just don't like the taste of the stuff. You know what? I've got enough hair on my chest, thank you very much. So why in the world am I doing this podcast? That's a good question. I've been a full-time reporter for more than 30 years now, and I love figuring out the story behind the story. For years now, I've heard stories about the connection between NASCAR, North Carolina, and moonshine. They seem shrouded in mystery and innuendo, whispers that have wafted through the state's mountains, valleys, and lowcountry for nearly a century now. My favorite NASCAR-themed movie of all time is Stroke a Race, starring Burt Reynolds, Lonnie Anderson, and Jim Neighbors. The theme song to that brilliant super speedway flick, performed by North Carolina native Charlie Daniels and his band, would seem to be perfect for this show and its purpose. Trust me, I'm not going to sing the song. I'll just quote a line or two. "Haul and Shine" was his regular line, till the track got in his blood.
Was a real hot shot and he bragged a lot, but man, that fool could drive. Cause he loved the feel of the steering wheel and the girls with the bedroom eyes. And in a racing tide or a barroom fight, old Stroker stole the show. A backstretch blazer, a real hellraiser, and a racetrack Romeo.
Like any good journalist, it's my goal on this show to separate fact from fiction. Wait a second. Good journalist? Hey, don't laugh. There are still a few of us around. That's all I'm going to say about that. How close was that connection in reality? What's the real connection between the illegal backwoods moonshine trade, a multi-billion dollar motorsports industry, and North Carolina? I'll be talking to folks from across the state, from professors to racers to legal distillers, as we try to sort it all out. So be sure and join me for the journey on the Moonshine and Motorsports Podcast, coming soon.